Please be seated. Good afternoon. My name is Carl Feeblecorn. I'm Senior Associate Dean for Student Professional Community Affairs here at the school. We welcome you to the School of Pharmacy and Pharmaceutical Sciences 172nd Divisional Commencement. Professor Philip Glick, Mace Bearer, Chair of the University Senate and Professor of Surgery and Management, will officially open the ceremony. Professor Glick.
Thank you very much. Trustee Fatah, President Tripathi, and the entire platform party. The graduates, the candidates for degrees, the faculty, the staff, and the parents, families, and friends of the graduates and candidates are now assembled. I hereby declare this commencement of the University of Buffalo to be open.
And now I will ask if you are able, please stand for our national anthem.
So proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs burst. Star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave. Please
be seated. I am pleased to announce some of today's platform party, SUNY Trustee Dr. Angelo Feta, Dr. Shatish Tripathi, University President, Dr. Michael Kane, Dean of the Medical School and Vice President for Health Sciences, Dr. Lee Melvin, Vice Provost for Enrollment Management, Dr. Beth Del Genio, Chief of Staff, Office of the President, Dean James O'Donnell, Dean of the School of Pharmacy and Pharmaceutical Sciences, Dr. Philip Glick, Professor of Surgery, Pediatrics, and Mace Bearer, Dr. Gordon L. Amadon, our keynote speaker, Ms. Renee Fleming, Alumni Association, honored guests and hooders, assistant and associate deans, distinguished professors, and faculty. It is my pleasure now to introduce President Tripathi to deliver his greetings.
Good evening. I would like to offer a warm welcome and a heartfelt thank you to the parents, family members, and friends joining us today. Your graduates have come this far in no small part thanks to your thoughtful guidance and your study support. And today we gather to recognize your graduates' achievement for the milestone it is and to celebrate the capstone of their hard work. With that, let me be among the first to wish the 2018 class of UB School of Pharmacy and Pharmaceutical Sciences congratulations. You have come a long way. Your journey to today has been marked by dedication and perhaps frustration, by study and self-reflection, by trial and error, by more late nights than you may care to remember. Along the way, you embraced new modes of thinking. You debated issues from different angles. You transferred your classroom learning to real-world challenges. You found your purpose and you pursued your passion. Throughout this transformative process of enlightenment, you have gained priceless knowledge about your field of study and, just as important, about yourself. So if I ask you, class of 2018, to single out the most important aspect of your academic program that has brought your education to life, what would that be? Don't worry, this is not a test. But as you embark on the next phase of your life, it is a question worth pondering. Although it has been many years since I sat where you sit today, I would argue that our most profound learnings do not just take place in a lecture hall. We do not read them in a textbook or discover them inside a lab. They don't come to us out in the field. Truth be told, education cannot be captured in a single moment. It is ongoing, continuous, constantly evolving. And with every stride we take, we seek a true understanding of respect given, and of respect earned. Respect, compassion, integrity, and justice are cornerstones of UB's guiding principles. We respect each other even when we are divergent, even when we have divergent life experiences. We respect those in our care by treating them compassionately. And we respect what we have learned by putting that precious knowledge to its best use, namely to address society's most pressing problems. Your UB education, truly the entire scope of your UB experience, has elevated your consciousness about the world around you. It has primed your sense of civic, professional, and ethical responsibility, values you will tap every day of your life. It has stoked your sense of purpose, indeed, your sense of greater purpose. At the start of the academic year, we welcome to campus Malala Yousafzai, the education rights activist who has earned respect the world over for her courage and her convictions. When Malala accepted the Nobel Peace Prize in 2014, she noted that progress and development were happening only in certain parts of the world. However, Malala said, there are many countries where millions suffer from the very old problems of war, poverty, and injustice. Malala continued by saying, let us become the first generation to decide to be the last that sees empty classrooms, lost childhoods, and wasted potentials. It is my sincere hope that your UB education has provided you with the intellectual resources, resources grounded in respect, compassion, integrity, and justice to do not only good things with your life, but to do great things with your life. Throughout your education, you have already done much in this regard. For instance, we have witnessed how you have created an award-winning program to educate high school students about the opioid epidemic, collected thousands of pounds of unused medications during the National Prescription Drug Take Back Day, and founded innovative ways to address health challenges such as chronic pain, lung cancer, and the overuse of antibiotics. Your education here has set the stage for the rest of your life. It is your time to put your imprint on the world around you by contributing to the world around you. Class of 2018, I have every confidence that as you go out into the world, you will make it better, brighter place. We look forward to seeing the impact of all of your accomplishments. Congratulations on your great achievement and all the best wishes on the road ahead.
It is now my pleasure to introduce James O'Donnell, Dean of the School of Pharmacy and Pharmaceutical Sciences, for his remarks.
It's a pleasure to welcome the class of 2018 who are receiving their degrees in pharmacy and pharmaceutical sciences, and those are here to recognize and celebrate their accomplishments. This includes our faculty and staff, our UB and SUNY colleagues, our alumni, and the family and friends of our graduates. I'd also like to recognize any other teachers in the audience. Our graduates don't arrive at this point by accident. In large measure, their success is due to elementary, middle, and high school teachers who have challenged them and nurtured them and opened their minds to the opportunities provided by higher education. For the graduates, I wish you the best, whether you're going into a job, pursuing advanced education, or residency, fellowship, or postdoctoral training. I'm confident that you have the knowledge and skills to be successful. You join an impressive group of past graduates who have provided healthcare to the community, advanced discovery in the pharmaceutical sciences, educated generations of scientists and pharmacists, and influence both clinical practice and healthcare policy. With graduation, you end your time as students, but not your connection to the school and to the University of Buffalo. Many of our alumni have contributed to your education and growth over the years. They interviewed you prior to admission, offered advice during orientation, served as preceptors or advisors, and provided key guidance and connections. I encourage you to do the same and share what you learn along the way with future students. The mission of our school is to improve health through innovation and leadership in pharmacy education, clinical practice, and research. You have been an important part of pursuing this mission, and you will continue to be so. You've been involved in significant research projects. You are already contributing to the care of patients, and you've engaged the larger scientific and professional communities. Moving forward, I wish you the best. I also encourage you to continue to build on what you have learned, to advocate for science and pharmacy practice, and to positively influence those around you. Thank you, and best wishes moving forward.
I now invite President Tripathi back to the podium to confer the State University of New York honorary doctorate degree to Dr. Gordon Amidon.
We take time at commencement to recognize noteworthy achievements of members of the larger UB community. Traditionally, we award State University of New York honorary doctoral degrees to distinguished individuals whose accomplishments and contributions are of special significance to UB and Western New York. These honorary degrees proposed by our campus and authorized by the SUNY trustees are conferred on individuals who represent the highest ideals of the University at Buffalo. Dr. Ange Farah, member of the State University of New York Board of Trustees, will join me now to confirm the 2018 State University of New York Honorary Doctorate. Would our recipient, Dr. Gordon Amidon, please come forward at this time? A renowned scholar, Dr. Gordon Amidon, has conducted research in the field of drug absorption that has benefited people the world over. Through this research, Dr. Amidon is credited with creating the biopharmaceutical classification system used to differentiate drugs based on their solubility and permeability. Dr. Amidon's work is recognized worldwide and serves as the foundation for the U.S. Food and Drug Administration's principles on determining generic drug bioequivalence. Regarded as a true visionary in his field, Dr. Amidon continues to break new ground at the University of Michigan, where he serves as the Charles R. Walgreen Professor of Pharmacy. For instance, he has created new approaches for predicting drug absorption in people prior to human studies, research that has greatly helped in drug design and development. Dr. Amidon discovered his passion for pharmacokinetics as an undergraduate student at UB in the 1960s, when the field was still emerging. Mentored by the field's pioneers, he developed a passion for understanding complex matters, setting the stage for a trailblazer career. Maintaining ties with his alma mater, Dr. Amidon has returned to UB to lecture, and he credits much of his later success to UB. A prolific author and a dedicated mentor, Dr. Amidon is one of UB's most distinguished alumni. He exemplifies the core of UB's academic mission, and his accomplishments are a source of great pride and inspiration to his alma mater. In recognition of Dr. Amidon's contribution to his field and of the profound impact of his work has had on a global scale, the University at Buffalo is privileged to confer upon him, on behalf of the State University of New York, a 2018 Honorary Doctor of Science.
By the authority of the trustees and the Chancellor of the State University of New York, and the Council and the Faculty of the University at Buffalo, I now confer upon Dr. Gordon Amidon the degree of Doctor of Science, honoris causa, with all of the rights and privileges thereto pertaining. In token thereof, I present this diploma and direct that he be vested with the hood appropriate to that degree.
Okay. Thank you, President DePatie. I must say I'm intimidated standing up here in front of you. 51 years ago, I was where you are. I'm both humbled and intimidated to be up here and saying, you have the basis, too, to have a career and to contribute to society. You've got the best education in the country, if not the world, and take advantage of that. Use that. I've particularly have taken a focus on pharmaceutical products. I'll say a little bit about what I've done. I focused on the product. I sometimes lecture saying there's no drug on the market. There's only drug product on the market. And so the product science is what I've been focusing on for the most part, most of my career. It contained the right combination of things. I can say 51 years ago where I was sitting where you are, it's like I didn't know where I would end up or where I would go. But sitting here looking at you today, I'm just totally humbled to receive this award from SUNY Buffalo. The initial condition that I had gave me the initial condition. Pharmaceutical sciences is very broad, many different career paths that you can take, community, into a hospital, therapeutic, into the science areas where I went. broadly, you have the broadest career options of maybe any disciplinary field that you studied, and so what you make of it is up to you, your energy over your life. Our job, remember, as pharmacist and pharmaceutical scientist, is to deliver a product
to the patient that works, right? Broadly, the pharmaceutical sciences and pharmacy delivers a product to the patient. Our whole medical care system depends on that product that works. And that's our responsibility, to ensure that the patient gets a product to work. It's one of the reasons I've worked in the regulatory science area to develop standards for pharmaceutical products, but that's our job. Broadly, pharmaceutical science has many different career paths, and I can't say enough about the initial basis. Buffalo and Michigan were two of the first schools to give academic degrees, scientific degrees in pharmacy 150 years ago. That basis has been the basis for my career. It was my initial condition. It's your initial condition. And now it's up to you to contribute to society, to contribute to the health of patients, not only in the U.S., but worldwide. So, again, I want to say thank you to President Tripathi, to the Board of Regents, SUNY Board of Trustees, for giving me this honor. I look at your young faces, and I'm totally humbled. I wish you all the best in your careers. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Amadon. It is now my pleasure to introduce Ms. Renee Rizzo Fleming, class of 1983, as a member of the UB Alumni Association, for her remarks.
Thank you, Carl. I am so excited to be here with you today. To be here with you, the graduating class of 2018, is pretty exciting for me. I remember when I was sitting in your seat. It's got to be one of the most important days of your life. So enjoy every minute of it. When I was trying to think of something that I could say today that you might remember tomorrow, I was thinking back to when I was sitting in your seat, and I thought, wow, I have a big challenge in front of me, because I honestly don't remember a whole lot about my graduation, so why would I expect you to remember anything I'm going to tell you? But I'm going to try. For many of you today, this is your last day as a student. And tomorrow is your first day of being a UB alumni. I want you to remember five numbers, okay? See if you guys can remember the five. 257,000, 113, 62,000, 7,200, and 154, okay? Today, you are part of 154 graduates in the UB School of Pharmacy and Pharmaceutical Sciences class of 2018. Tomorrow, you will join the ranks of over 7,200 active pharmacy grads, 62,000 UB young alumni who have graduated in the last 10 years, and 257,000 UB grads living in 113 countries around the world. Your connection to UB does not end today with graduation. As part of the ranks of alumni, you can take advantages of many services and resources that are available to you through the Alumni Association, and you can give back to the university by helping UB students of the future. After the celebration is over, today, tomorrow, somewhere along the line, reality is going to set in. You will start to work on your goals for the future. There are young alumni and established UB grads around the world who are waiting to help you on your journey. On the UB alumni website, if you click on the Career Connector Network, which I'm on, you can create a profile and start getting connected one-on-one with other alum to get career advice and tips. You can also sign up for UB in the City, which is happening in June, just a month away. That's an online networking event in June when you can connect with recent grads from all over the world to help you get real-world advice on your journey. Don't forget, You also want to get involved with the young alumni group who sponsor tons of fun events. And I want to go to one myself, but I guess I'm past the young alumni stage, but I think I'm going to try to sneak into a few of them. And professional development workshops and seminars. So even if you're not living in the area, there's a lot of webinars and workshops that you can access online. Now, it is also your turn to step up and be an active role model for the pharmacy students of the future. Make a point to join the Dean's Alumni Ambassadors and assist with the e-reviews and the interviewing process of pharmacy applicants of the future. Become a pharmacy alumni mentor or preceptor, and stay involved in those professional organizations that you are involved in as a student. And be a guest speaker. I bet you had heard a few guest speakers while you were in pharmacy school. Well, things have switched now, and you're going to be the guest speaker and being able to share your experiences with the future pharmacists. So, in closing, yes, I'm almost done. There are five numbers, 154, 7200, 62,000, 257,000, and 113. Today, you're part of 154 graduates. Tomorrow, you'll be part of 7,200 pharmacy alumni, 62,000 young alumni, and 257,000 UB grads living in 113 countries around the world. You have an awesome network of UB alumni to draw on in the future and to become a part of. And please try and find ways to stay active in your school and give back. Congratulations to all of you. I hope the future holds bright things for all of you. Thank you.
Thank you. And now I ask Dean O'Donnell and President Tripathi to advance to the podium for the degrees. The degrees authorized by the trustees and chancellors of the State University of New York and the council and the faculty of the University of Buffalo will now be conferred. Please hold your applause till all the candidates have received their respective degrees. The candidates for the degree Bachelor of Science in Pharmaceutical Sciences will now be presented. Will the candidates please rise?
This degree is awarded following completion of a four-year program with a major in pharmaceutical sciences. President Tripathi, on behalf of the faculty of the School of Pharmacy and Pharmaceutical Sciences, I have the honor of recognizing these candidates. They have met all the requirements of the university and are recommended to you by the faculty for the degree Bachelor of Science in Pharmaceutical Sciences.
By the authority of the trustees and the Chancellor of the State University of New York and the Council and the faculty of the University at Buffalo, I now confer upon you the degree Bachelor of Science in Pharmaceutical Sciences with all the rights and privileges thereto pertaining. Congratulations.
Should have done any more push-ups, I think. Maybe that's... It's going to be slow. The graduates will come forward and receive a certificate of recognition on this occasion. Pharmaceutical science graduates will be announced by Dr. Kathleen Bojay, Associate Professor and Associate Dean for Academic Affairs. Dr. Bojay.